session or in the first session of this cell lesson, we saw about the organisms show variety in their cell and how there is a discovery of a cell by the Robert Koch, Eric Dresser, and I saw about the organism that show variety in their cell number, shape and size. About that we are learning here. So here, as you know, number of the cells are there, they are varying in a different organism, and there is a biodiversity we are observing on the earth, variety of the plants and animals or all living organisms which we are observing. In that, there is the number of the cells are there, they are varying. And here, if organism is small, means there is a thousands, billions, billions cells are present in the different organisms as per their body structure. And every cell of the organism, like there is a organism having the unicellular and organism in multicellular. Unicellular is the organism which are made up of a single cell. They are the unicellular organisms. And the organisms which are made up of many cells, more than one cell, that are called as a multicellular organism. So we observe that there are the many organisms are there. Like from if we are going to be from ant to the elephant, there is the size of the animals are there or size of the plants are there. They are varying. And as per their structure, their size, there are number of cells are there. They are more or less in number. It is different in every organism. And also there is the shape and sizes are there. Here in the organism body, cells are that cells which we are learning about the cell number, shape and size. About the shape now we are going to learn. So yesterday we saw about unicellular, multicellular, like a single cell from like amoeba, paramecium is there, and which can perform all the cell activities, all the functions. They are metabolic activities, they are carried out by the single cell, like amoeba, paramecium, the organisms which are made up of a single cell. But the organism which are made up of a many cells, they are multicellular. They have a different systems, organ systems are present, and so that organ systems are carrying out a different function. They have their specific function. Digestive system has a digestion. Respiratory system is there. It is related with the breathing. Circulatory blood circulation is there. Excretory system or waste products which are going to form in the body, that are going to here sent outside the body. So like this, they have a different here structures are there and our different systems are there, and it's a particular, they have their particular own functions are also there. But in unicellular organism, they have here only single cell can perform here all the activities, metabolic activities like digestion, respiration, excretion, growth, everything which are going to perform by the multicellular organism in different parts of the body. So here we learn that is the number of the cells. Now we are going to learn about the shape of the cells. So you learn about the amoeba. So amoeba structure is there. Amoeba structure, whenever you are going to draw, there is no any particular fixed shape is there for the amoeba. Amoeba is made up of a single cell. But here, when you are observing the shape of the amoeba, it is a irregular in shape. It has not any fixed shape. If amoeba you want to draw like this, otherwise if you are going to draw like this, no any fixed structure is there for the amoeba. It has an irregular shape. When here there are projections, amoeba body is there, that is made up of a single cell, and that single cells are there, they will protrude outside the body, or that are called as projections are there. From this cell it will come out, and that projections are called as pseudopodia. That projections are called as a pseudopodia. So here amoeba is made up of a single cell, and here amoeba body which is irregular in shape, it has not any fixed shape. So here, because in fact amoeba has no definite shape, unlike other organism body you are observing, they have a fixed definite shape is there. But amoeba which is made up of a single cell, it is a irregular in shape which has not a definite shape. So it keeps on changing its shape with the help of that the projections which are coming out, protruding out. So the projection of a variety different type of projections, not the same length projections are there coming out, protruding out of the body, and the projection which will come out at acquired is pseudopodia. Pseudo means a pit. So here it will use that one, false pit. Pseudo means a false pit, means a
is a, it will use amoeba is going to use that pseudopodia. So pseudo means a falsum and podia means a food. So it is behaving like a false feeder and which is using amoeba for the movement and for the feeding purpose. Here there is another cell is there means a, in your upper body there are blood components are there. As you know, blood components are the blood is our here blood is made up of a four components, which are that one like a RBC, WBC, plasma and platelets. So here all these four are there combining, then the blood is there. We are observing that means blood component in our blood, these four components are present. In that WBC which is present in our body, that WBC has also no any fixed shape. So white blood cell in a human dead is another example of a single cell which changed its shape. That white blood cell is there, it has not fixed the shape, it is changing its shape. And so it's going to change always. Like amoeba, how it has not a definite shape like that. Here WBC which is present in a human blood, it is also going to change its shape. So but WBC is a cell. See here, WBC is a, it is a one type of a cell. And here amoeba is there. This amoeba is an organism. See how there is a difference in the WBC and the amoeba. Both are changing their shape, but WBC is a cell which is present in our blood, which is a component in our blood, one of the component of the blood. But amoeba is one of the organism which is going to take place, or all the metabolic activities are there. It is taking place in the body of the amoeba with the help of a single cell, and which has irregular in shape and which is going to change its shape again. So that is the difference in both. So here there is the next point. There are, as we are observing in our body or in other organism body, there are the different types of cells are present. So cells are there. Say, what shape would you expect organism with a million of a cells? There are organisms out there, in that organism million cells are present in the body. So if we are observing, there is a diagrammatic representation on page number 137, you are going to observe there are the different structures are there for the cells, like a spherical red blood cells are there. Spherical red blood cells are we are observing. Also there is a spindle shaped muscle cells are there, that one we are observing. Spindle shaped tapping at the both ends of muscle cells are there. And another structure is there of the cell, that is the nerve cell we are observing. So all these shapes of the cells are there. They are different, which is present in our body, but they have different shapes are there. So here it shows the blood, muscle and nerve in a human being. The different shapes are related to their specific function. These are the different shapes. Like red blood cells are present in the blood. Here, muscle cells are there. In our muscles they are present. Nerve cells are there, which are sending and receiving the messages. So, nervous system is there. That is, in that nervous system is made up of a nervous cell. So, these are the different, we are observing different types of a cell, and it has their different shapes of the cell, which has their its four functions are there. Generally, cells are there, they are round, spherical, and elongated. Some cells are there, long, pointed, both ends. Generally, they are the round, spherical, and elongated structures are there. But some are there, pointed, tapering, both ends are there, some are there, like a branch, you are there, over here. They exhibit a spindle shaped structure, some are. And cells some are there quite long, while they are branched like the nerve cells. Are there, they are longer one, and branchable structures are there like the root structures we are observing, which are the longer one and branchable. They are nothing but they are the nerve cells, or also called as a nerve cell is also called as a amoeba. This is like a red blood cell is there, these are the muscle cells are there, this is the nerve cell. So some are spherical is there, otherwise here elongated round shapes are there, and so there are the spindle shapes are there, tapping both ends or pointed at the both ends, that are the muscle cells. Some are there, long elongated one, and which are the branch of one, like the nerve cell, also called as the neuron. And the nerve cell receives and transfer the messages, so thereby it is helping to it. It has its own shape.
And these shapes are there. Which part of the shape give that shape? And this part of the shape giving the, that is called the cell membrane. So cell membrane gives here, cell membrane is there that gives the shape for the cell.
So here, components of the cell are enclosed in a membrane, and this membrane provides a shape to the cells of plants and animals. This membrane is there, that membrane provides us. See, this is the cell membrane. Also, covering, as you know, you are trying to see the structure of a plant cell, animal cell. So the outer covering is there, that is called as a cell membrane, and that cell membrane is giving the shape for the cell.
So it is nothing but a here component of the cells are enclosed. The many components like the cytoplasm that are enclosing into the cell membrane, and this cell membrane provides a shape to the here shape for the cells of the plants and animals. Shape here like even if plant body is there for the plant, there is the here cell wall is there which gives the shape for the cell, and this is the animal cell. Animal cell has only cell membrane is there which gives the shape for the animal cell. Here, this is the plant cell. For the plant cell, there is another one of the outer covering is there that is called as the cell wall. Cell wall gives the shape for the cell. Here, animal cell is there. For the animal cell, cell membrane is there. And in the plant cell, cell membrane and outer covering, another one layer is there outer, that is called as the cell wall. Additional covering of the cell membrane and the plant cell, and it gives the cell wall, gives the shape and definitely for the cell. For the bacteria also, there is the another covering, that is the cell wall is present, which gives the shape for the cell. Bacteria itself also has a cell wall. So cell wall is present in the plant cell and the bacteria. In the animal cell, only cell membrane is there and which gives the shape for that cell. So this is about the shape of the cell. Next one, about the size of the cell is there, about that we are learning. So here, next one is there, that is about the size of the cell. What is the size of the cell? The size of the cell is very important. The brain is small as a millionth of a meter, and up here also as a maybe large as a few centimeter. So it is a millionth of meter smaller is there, as a few centimeter larger is there. It is a very big size. So size of the cell in living organism different one. However, most of the cells are microscopic in size and are not visible to under the eye. So mostly all cells are there. They are here microscopic one. Mostly cells are there. They are microscopic, and that's here they are microscopic one, which we are not able to see by the here unaided eye. Here it is not visible for our unaided eye. They are the microscopic one. Size of the cells are there. It is varying mostly here. Mostly most cells are there. They are microscopic one. They need to enlarge by the magnifying microscope. So when we are taking a magnifying microscope, magnifying means it becomes a larger one. Enlarging the size, whatever the size of the cell is there, when in the microscope we are observing with the help of lens, it is going to see as an enlarged form. So that is called as a magnifying microscope. The smallest cell is there, 0.1 to 0.5 micrometer in the bacteria. In bacteria, bacteria is a very smaller one are there, and the size are there, 0.1 to 0.5 micrometer is there. And the largest cell is there, here, 170 millimeter to the 130 millimeter, that is the egg puppet of the ostrich. Ostrich egg, we were observing, hen egg, we were observing. They are larger one. In that larger one cell is there, that is the ostrich egg is there. So, are the cells of animal larger than the rat? No, all cells, that is the cells which are present in rat, otherwise cells which are present in the elephant. They are not enough, means a big elephant, big animals are not a larger cells, or small animals are not a here smaller cells. So here, whatever shape of the cell, size of the cell is there, it is mostly same in the all animals, but number of cells are there, they are more in the elephant. Number of cells are there, they are less in the rat. See what I'm telling? Size of the cell, it is mostly same only. It is not varying. As it is not depend on that size of the animal. So here, but there is the number of the cells are more in the elephant, and number of the cells are less in the rat. Number of the cells are only I'm telling. So here, there is a trillions of cells. there the thousand media, or millions of cells are there. We are observing like the, in the rat, rabbit, deer, we are going to observe. As there the here, size of the animal, here, bigger one or larger one, number of cells are there that are increasing. But the shape of the cell is there, it is mostly same. So the size of the cell has no relation with the size of the body. That's what we are going to. There is a no relation between the size of the here, the size of the cell and the size of the body of the animal. Whatever the size of the body of the animal, the size of the cell is also here. Same in the small and the large animals. It is not necessarily cells in any body are much bigger than the draft. The size of the cell is related to its function. So size of the cell is there. What its function is there, it is related to that function. So for example, nerve cells are there. Both are there in the elephant and the rat. They are long and angular. In the both, rat and the elephant, nerve cells are there. They are both, it means the nerve cells are there in both animals, rat and the elephant. They are long and branchable one, and their function is there like a sending and receiving, transferring of the message, controlling and coordinating of the body. So they perform the same function and that is the transferring of message. So here this is about the cell structure and the function shape of the cells and also about the size of the cells about that. So